You might say that electric eels need no introduction. Most people have heard of them and are aware of their unusual ability to generate powerful electrical discharges for offense and defense. The electric eel has a slender, snake-like body and flattened head. Its thick, scaleless skin is generally dark gray to brown, and its underside is a yellow-orange color. Electric eels are sluggish creatures that prefer slow-moving fresh water where they surface every few minutes to gulp air. Their mouth is rich with blood vessels that allow the use of the mouth as a lung. The vestigial gills are used only to eliminate carbon dioxide, not for oxygen uptake. Similar to other eel-shaped fish, the electric eel lacks pelvic fins. It has a small or reduced caudal fin and also lacks dorsal fins. Instead, an elongated anal fin helps it maneuver through the water where it can swim forward, backward, or hover as it searches for prey. Three specialized electric organs, the main electrical organ, the hunter's organ, and the sex organ, make up about 80% of the fish's body. Its remaining vital organs are tightly packed within the anterior or front part of its body. The main electrical organ is located on the dorsal side. It spans the middle half of the body from just behind the head to the middle of the tail. Hunter's organ parallels the main organ, but on the ventral side. Those organs generate the high-voltage pulses that stun prey and deter predators. The rear quarter of the electrical eel contains sex organ, which produces lower-voltage pulses that allow the electric eel to communicate and navigate murky waters. Sex organ also contains the electric eel's negative pole. An electric eel can deliver a shock because its nervous system contains a number of disc-shaped electrogenic electricity-producing cells called electrocytes. Each electrocyte carries a net negative electric charge. The electrocyte's inner periphery is negatively charged and has a potential difference of just under 100 millivolts relative to the deeper parts of the cell's interior, which has a high concentration of positively charged potassium ions. When the shock command is delivered to these cells by the neurotransmitter acetylcholine, a path of low electrical resistance develops between one side of the cell and the interior. Through active transport, potassium ions outside the cell rush inward on that side, which causes some of the potassium ions inside the cell to exit the other side to maintain the cell's equilibrium. With this process, about 50 millivolts of electricity is released from the cell. Since the electrogenic cells are stacked next to one another, the activity of one cell firing sets off others around it, creating a cascade of current. The collective discharge of electricity from each electrocyte in the chain allows the electric eel to release up to 860 volts. Studies have shown that shocks from juvenile electric eels making leaping attacks can discharge more than 120 volts, which, after other factors are considered, can impart 40 to 50 milliamps of current on its victim, an amount large enough to cause intense pain in humans. Electric eels have been shown to curl their bodies around larger or more elusive prey. That strategy has the effect of doubling the strength of the electric field between the electric eel's positive pole, which is located near the head, and its negative pole, which is located near the tail. The electric eel then delivers a series of shocks that occur at 1-millisecond intervals. Each shock forces involuntary muscle contractions that fatigue the prey's muscles, which allow the electric eel to better manipulate it for consumption. Electric eels may also use their ability to shock other animals to defend themselves against predators and perceived threats. While an electric eel is fully submerged, its electrical discharge is weaker because the shock is distributed throughout the surrounding water. Stronger shocks, however, may be delivered by leaping out of the water or by extending the head up and out of the water to place the chin against a partially submerged animal. The strength of the electric current delivered in this fashion is not dampened by the watery medium. The electric current enters the animal's body directly before traveling through the submerged parts of its body and back into the water to the tail of the electric eel, thereby completing the electric circuit. Can electric eels kill you? What started as an ordinary fishing trip for a Brazilian man ended in shocking video footage that went viral. After throwing a line into the Amazon and realizing he'd caught an electric eel, the man reeled up the eel to the riverbank and left to retrieve a knife. When he returned, something else was sizing up the catch of the day. A caiman had saddled up next to the eel. As the fisherman hit record on his smartphone, the big reptile went in for the kill and died as the eel delivered a violent electric shock. If you were to encounter a shock from an electric eel, would it kill you? Although there are few documented instances of people dying from an electric eel shock, it could happen. A single jolt could incapacitate a person long enough to cause him or her to drown, even in shallow water. Multiple shocks could cause a person to stop breathing or go into heart failure. Whether the shock of an electric eel is fatal also may depend on the size of the eel, which, by the way, isn't actually an eel at all. The electric eel, Electrophorus electricus, is a fish classified in the order Gymnotiformes and is a cousin to the carp and catfish. Electric eels populate the streams, rivers, and ponds of South America and can grow as long as 8 feet, 2.5 meters, and as heavy as 44 pounds, 20 kilograms. Although eels live in the water, these serpentine-shaped creatures surface frequently to breathe air. Even when they don't feel threatened, they emit a constant electric charge of about 10 volts, which acts as a radar to help them find their way in muddy waters. They also use the electric charge to identify fish, amphibians, and birds to eat. A full-grown electric eel will generate about 600 volts of electricity in short, intense bursts that last only about 2 milliseconds. This electrical charge comes from thousands of muscle cells that each create a tiny current. A 6-foot eel, for example, has about 6,000 muscle cells working together to generate those 600 volts, which is quintuple the voltage contained within a standard wall socket in the United States. While it's unclear why an eel is able to shock and sometimes electrocute, that is, kill something with the shock, other fish, fowl, and amphibians without delivering fatal voltage to its own body, there are a few theories. One such theory is that the eel may feel the shock, but it's built up such a resistance that it doesn't suffer the detrimental effects.